Colin Travis from Chaparral Motorsports here, and yesterday was an amazing day. I was here by my computer watching your Instagram and Facebook posts go up while you were out at the Deegan compound testing the brand new 60 helmets. The footage I saw was pretty epic. So can you tell us a little bit about the day and kind of how that got started?
Yeah, Kyle, yesterday was an awesome day. We got to go down to Brian Deegan's compound in Temecula, California. 60 launched their new ATR2 helmet, which is the second generation of their ATR1. I was completely impressed with the technology that they have in this new helmet. And a lot of people maybe had the mindset that they were just going to shave a couple, you know, items or features on the ATR1 helmet. They didn't. They actually constructed a completely new helmet. The only thing that they reused were the visor screws wow. and the D-rings. I think the ATR2 helmet consists of just about 121 pieces. The most impressive part is the fact that the EPS liner is replaceable. I think that's super beneficial to riders and racers nowadays. I mean, I'm a racer myself. I know what tires cost. I know what it costs to buy gear and replace an exhaust if you crash. So if you go out and you buy a $700 helmet and you just happen to take a digger a month later, and you just compress the EPS liner inside, essentially that helmet is no good. Well, 60 offers a program to where you can send the helmet into their facility in Brea, California, and if the shell is not compromised or cracked, you can actually replace the EPS liner, I think it extends the life of an MX helmet. And nowadays, you know, the bikes are getting faster, the roost is getting way more extreme behind these 450s. And I think having a very safe helmet on your head with the motocross tracks nowadays, it's really important.
So he actually got to put these helmets on and test them on the track there at the Deegan compound. Now, that was the first time you ever hit a ramp, right?
Yeah, it was.
Pretty cool. So you got little Danger Boy hitting the ramp, and then you see Travis come behind him. Brah, brah.
Yeah,
pretty
I made myself look real old.
But the technology behind these helmets is absolutely astounding. So if you're not familiar, 60 in the past had these little nubs here that were in between the two layers. That way you get movement and compression.
The dampers. Yeah.
Now, the new version of this helmet is absolutely spectacular. The amount of technology in that helmet here. Take a look at this picture.
What you're going to notice is a replaceable inner EPS liner. Now, that's the liner I was talking about if you were to get in a crash and not crack the shell. There's a multi-impact outer EPP liner, which is a new material that they learned about. The progressive EPP dampening towers, which we'll get into that. Those are those new orange discs that you see in that image right there. Low friction discs, isolation dampeners, increased ODS displacement travel by 30%, which means that they took those hourglass shaped dampers and they were able to gain more travel out of those by 30%. They also improved the liner and the angular acceleration mitigation.
Dude, that's pretty incredible. A 30% increase in movement. So basically these little dots up here, obviously this is the old construction, and you saw in that image we just showed you on the screen, the new construction, but basically the way that this shifts on the inside now has 30% more movement. That's huge.
Yeah.
Now, a lot of that technology came from a program that they participated in with the NFL, is that correct?
Yeah, you're right, Kyle. They participated in what's called the Head Challenge 3. Now, this started in 2014, and what it is it's a challenge that the NFL puts on for helmet manufacturers. So there was 125 helmet manufacturers that entered this Head Challenge. 5 finalists, 1 winner. 6D was awarded $250,000 because of their ODS technology, which is basically the little red dampers that they've created, the ODS, omnidirectional suspension.
So if what I learned yesterday was correct, they have that $250,000 that they earned for being the number one winner of that Head Challenge 3. They then took that money and reinvested that back into making their already amazing helmet even more perfect using the technology and materials that they learned were superior from the other helmet manufacturers that participated in the test.
Yeah, 60, they learned a lot of new different materials that they could use into their MX helmet from the NFL. And I think that 4-year head challenge was very beneficial to 60 and the safety that they provide for a typical dirt bike guy like myself or the racers that race every Saturday night.
So the NFL, new technology, new materials, new action, new shell sizes and new shell shapes. There's lots of changes here at the 6D line. Now that's all the technical stuff. Now you actually put this helmet on and rode the track yesterday with little Deegan boy. So can you tell me a little bit about your impressions of this helmet while wearing it on the track?
Yeah, what I can tell you is the helmet, initially when I put my head into it, felt very comfortable. They changed the cheek pads dramatically to where they contour around your jawline. And I really love that because it gives you that extra support, that kind of the hugging feeling around your face. It vented very well. As you noticed, they are slimmer in size. It's not as wide. It's a lot slimmer in design. Thankfully, I didn't get to test the impact protection, but all in all, the helmet was exceptional. I'm very impressed with what 6D has to offer and what they put out on the table with this ATR2.
And that's something I really like about 6D is the fact that they are not resting on their laurels. They're not just taking a helmet and producing new colors and new graphics every year so you want to buy a new helmet. They're actually spending time, money, and effort in the lab researching what will make the next best helmet. And that, I think, is really impressive.
And just to go off of that, a lot of helmets are DOT approved that are sold in the U.S. Mm-hmm. That's because any helmet that's sold in the U.S. has to be DOT approved. Mm-hmm. They exceed DOT. Not only that, but they go and get an ECE approval. They go get an Australian approval. And there's another approval that I don't even know. There's no reason for them to get them. But just knowing that they have these stamps of approval and the helmet exceeds those, I think that's something to say.
And there you have it, the ATR2, not yet released, but will be here shortly, will become the world's most protective motorcycle helmet, according to 6D and those who have tested it. So another neat thing we learned is the ATR1 is not going to be removed from the line. It's still going to stay here, but the price point is going to drop as the technology has become older, if you will. So the new helmet's going to come in just above the current price point for this one here, and then this one's going to drop a couple $100. So even if this was previously out of your price range and you love the technology, you can probably now get into one of these for a pretty inexpensive price point.
Yeah, you're right, Kyle. The new ATR2 is going to have a retail price of $695. That was the same retail price of the ATR1. Okay. So what they're going to do is bring the ATR1 price down. They mentioned $525. I don't know if they were rock solid about that price, but $525 for the same type of technology that they've offered for the past 4 years is very impressive. I know some of you have been saving up to just get an ATR1. Maybe you're at $500 now and you're right around the corner from getting one. Don't be alarmed because the ATR2 is out on the market and you might think it's better than the ATR1. The ATR1 still has great results, and they did show that in the seminar. They showed the results of the ATR1 and then the ATR2. And the ATR2 is just above the ATR1, so it's pretty impressive.
There you go, the brand new ATR2 from 6D. It'll be released when, Travis?
Mid-March. We're gonna have some colors up on our website soon so you guys can pre-order them. So head to shapmoto.com and check them out. All right, guys, so there you have it, the ATR2 helmet. I got to see it for the first time at Brian Deegan's house in Temecula, and I had an awesome time. I mean, some of the kids showed me up on the 65s and the 85s, but let me tell you, the helmet is very impressive, as I said. And I'm really excited to bring them into Chaparral. We're gonna have them on our website mid-March. You can pre-order them yourself. And when they do get here, be sure to come on in and try one on yourself. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. It only takes one click. And just throw another click in there and give us a like. I'm Travis, this is Kyle. Thanks for watching.